Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ashley. I'm a YouTuber based in Port Harcourt. So in today's video, I want to share with you guys four tips that I used to get my toddler to be able to play by herself without needing attention, without seeking attention for 20-30 minutes. Independent play is a skill that children learn, and to be honest, is a lifesaver. Initially, I would be able to get her to play on her own for 5 minutes, for 10 minutes, and within that period, there's only so much I can do. Maybe I can just quickly wash the dishes or something really brief. But right now, I can get her to play on her own for 20-30 minutes without, you know, looking for who will carry her or looking for who to talk to or anything like that. And I decided, let me share those tips with you guys so, you know, it can help someone. The first thing I started doing was to always play with her, especially when she started getting more curious about her environment, about objects around and everything. So I started surrounding her with more toys, but I'll play with her. I'll squat, sit on the floor with her and play. If it's a toy that she doesn't entirely understand, because there are some toys that she did not understand at first, I will show her how it works. If it's maybe a musical instrument or something that I have to switch it on at some point before it would function properly, you know, I'll show her all of that. So the first 1 month or two, I would always sit with her and play with her when it's play time. I never leave her on her own. Then after that, the second thing I started to do was to step back and just observe. I was doing that for two reasons. First, I wanted to figure out which was her favorite. So when I put so many toys around her and I'm observing, I'm trying to figure out which one she loves to play with the most, the ones she ignores and the ones she concentrates on, so that subsequently I can always, you know, put the ones that she prefers around her than the ones that she ignores. And another reason why I was doing that is because I wanted her to start, you know, finding all these toys exciting without me, you know, pushing it onto her. That is, I just put the toys in front of her on her own, you know. I just wanted her to learn how to just pick them up on her own and play with them without me having to say, oh this is Bunny, oh this is her. I wanted that to stop, which eventually started working. At first, after like 2-3 minutes, she'll just leave. Once she notices that I'm not beside her again, she'll just leave the toys and come to where I am. But with time, she started to play on her own, especially when I'm observing, not to have my phone with me or to be doing any other thing that would distract me. Because I noticed that when she's playing and she looks at me and I'm not looking at her, maybe I'm looking at the TV or I'm pressing my phone or something, she will leave everything that she's doing and come to me and, you know, try and join me in doing whatever I'm doing. But when I'm not doing anything distracting and I'm just staring at her and she looks at me and I smile at her, I say hi, or that, she'll smile back and go back to her play. So yeah, the second thing that I did to help her develop independent play was to just sit back and observe, but concentrate on her. Don't do any other thing. I just concentrate on her until she stopped caring whether I'm looking at her or not. The third thing I started to do was find an activity for myself too while she's playing in the same room. It could be ironing, it could just be folding clothes, or just, you know, going through Instagram or anything. I just had to start doing something that will make her know that, even make her understand that she can be playing, we can be in the same room, but I don't have to, you know, always focus on her. I wanted it to start being normal to her that, you know, the world doesn't evolve around her. I'm just kidding. But yeah, I just wanted her to start playing on her own without worrying whether mommy is staring at her or whoever is in the room with her is staring at her. And at first, it was kind of difficult because she will leave. Once I start doing something, she will stop being curious about what she is doing and want to, you know, join me in whatever I'm doing, especially when it's things like folding clothes and all that. But with time, you know, I just kept encouraging her, or I'll make sure what I'm doing is where her hands can't get to. Like when I'm ironing, her hand cannot get to what I'm doing. So when she notices that, okay, I can't actually join mom in this thing that she's doing, let me as well just go back to my toy. So yes, with time, it now became normal. Two of us will be in the same room, but we'll both be minding our business. She'll be playing with her toys and I'll be doing what I, you know, have to do. Then the fourth thing I started to do after, you know, I've accomplished the first three very well, was to start leaving her alone in the room, but just for a brief moment, you know, not for too long, and most of the time I try to tell her, okay Nora, I'll be right back, let mommy just go and do the dishes and I'll just go and come back as quick as possible. At first I'll try and come back 10-15 minutes, because when I stay longer she will come and look for me. But now, you know, as she has gotten older, she's interested in more things, she has gained more independence, I can now go for 20-30 minutes, but I always come back. I try to make sure that I come back to her and not her coming to look for me. Even if what I initially went to do I finished and I'm tempted to do something else, since she's still concentrating on, you know, what she's doing, but most of the time I don't fall for that temptation, I go back. So she will know that I'll always come back, and she will stop being curious about coming to look for me, which I think is why we've gotten to 20-30 minutes of independent play without her looking for me, because she knows that even though, yes, I've left the room, yes, she is alone, but I am still going to come back. And sometimes I try to talk to her from where I am, like when she, I believe she's calling for attention, when she blabs, I reply her, I call her name, I tell her, mommy will be right back, I'm coming, I'll be with you shortly. And most of the time it calms her down, she'll just, you know, not say anything again or not come and look for me, she'll just continue with her play. So these are the four things that I have done, or I did to get us to where we are now of 30 minutes independent playtime. And let me just run through the four things one more time. Why am I sounding weird? One more time. First thing is, I start to play with her a lot, start to engage with her, interact with her and all her toys and everything, even though it always felt weird sometimes. But yes, first thing I did was to always play with her. Second thing I did was I started to sit back and observe and just watch her play, and, you know, not say anything to her, not try and distract her or things like that. Then the third thing I started to do was to also find activities to do for myself, so she will know that it's completely normal for her to be busy and for me to be busy. I cannot always just concentrate on her, so she would know that, okay, I have other, mommy has other things to do aside attending to me. And after we did that, the next thing I now started to do was to leave her alone in the room and go and do something else. But I always make sure she's in a safe place. I always try to remove everything that might hurt her and just allow her to, you know, allow her enjoy her creativity, explore her environment and play on her own. So these are the four things that I did to get us to where we are now. And now baby girl can go like 20-30 minutes. Like, I can go and shower, brush my teeth, wash my hair and come back, and she's still there playing without any care in the world, even though most of the time I still try to put her in a confined space like this, her crib. I don't know if you guys can see, just so I'm really sure that she's not going anywhere else and she's just there. So yes, these are the four tips I learned and used to get Nora to play independently. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. See you in my next video. Bye.